गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू टू दिस सेशन ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेशन एंड एयर कंडीशनिंग। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम धीराज मंडल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, JIS कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द लेक्चर नंबर 23, दैट इज योर रेफ्रिजरेशन कंपोनेंट्स एंड कंट्रोल पार्ट टू। यू नो दैट लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस द compressor part. So the refrigeration components are mainly four components are there. By the help of that, a refrigeration effect is obtained. So there you know that in a refrigeration cycle what happened, it is consisting of four main components, like your evaporator, compressor, condenser and expansion valve. So these four devices which are mainly used for the refrigeration effect, the function of evaporator is to evaporate the entire refrigerant, and when it is evaporating, then at that time what we will see that the system temperature is taken by this refrigerant, and so system latent heat is taken and it is changing its phase and come to the compressor. In the compressor it is compressed, so the temperature and pressure is raised and volume is decreasing here. Now from the compressor it is coming to the condenser, where it is condensed. The refrigerant is condensed and again the phase is changing by releasing the latent heat to the surrounding, and at the outlet of the condenser what we are getting, high pressure low temperature liquid refrigerant, and then it is entering into the expansion valve, that is your isenthalpic process. So it is nothing but a copper tube, capillary tube, that will be discussed in this coming lecture. So in this capillary tube or your throttling device, here the expansion is taking place. Suddenly pressure is falling down as the volume is increasing, and as a result temperature is decreasing. So at the outlet of the expansion valve we are getting very low temperature, low pressure liquid refrigerant. So this liquid refrigerant is again entering into the evaporator part, and the evaporator is again experiencing some external heat which is entering into the system. Then again it is again this process is, and then again the latent heat is taken by this liquid refrigerant, and again it is coming to the compressor part. So these are the four devices. This is your compressor, evaporator, capillary tube or expansion device, and the condenser part. Okay, so by the help of these four devices, a lower temperature region can be maintained in your home. You must have seen the fridge, AC which is operated. Okay, so by the help of this process, a deep freeze where you are making ice cube or your packaged food or any kind of food material, you are reserving that in this particular region, and we will see that it is basically protecting the to spoil that particular food. Okay, so by the help of this refrigeration process, we have seen that the particular and lower temperature region can be maintained. Now here last class we have discussed this compressor part, where in compressor you have seen that there are mainly reciprocating compressor, rotary compressor, centrifugal compressor. Also we will be discussing the screw compressor. So this reciprocating compressor was discussed in last class in details, but today we will be discussing the rest of the compressor, that is your rotary compressor, centrifugal compressor and screw compressor. So let us start. So reciprocating compressor, here you just one minute I want to recapitulate you that it is basically to and fro motion or reciprocating by the help of reciprocating motion, the refrigerant is entering from, which is coming from the evaporator, and it is compressed, and at the outlet of the compressor we are getting high pressure, high temperature refrigerant which is coming to the condenser. Okay, so this compressor is basically, it is this compressor is what I want to say, that it is used to compress the refrigerant. Okay, now what happened, this reciprocating compressor here, low pressure vapor and high pressure vapor, you can see in the red and blue, in the red and this green, your light green figure, your color, you can see this is your high pressure pressure vapor and low pressure vapor. Okay, so but just what we are seeing that it is basically reverse of the ICE engine. Now the rotary compressor, it is, you can see in this figure the vane type of compressor is shown. So there are two type of rotary compressor, your one is a roller type rotary compressor and another one is a vane type rotary compressor. So vane type rotary compressor, let us discuss how it is operated, how it is working. So the vane, in a vane type rotary compressor, two or more number of vane are mounted in the slot of rotor mounted on the eccentric. The vane position is controlled as the rotor rotates. They can be used up to 180 Kelvin temperature. The compression ratio is limited to 7:1 and has very high volumetric efficiency, 70-85%, since no residual gas expands in this case. Okay, the rotary compressor is most suited in pumping refrigerant having moderate or low condensing pressure, such as R221, that is your refrigerant R21 and R114, and this is mainly used for domestic refrigerator. So in the figure, the vane type rotary compressor, you can see, and you can see the rotor, you can see the casing, spring loaded vane slides in the slot cut in rotor drum, and it is the inlet. This is your inlet and this is the outlet or delivery of, to the condenser. So from the evaporator section, the refrigerant is entering into the system, into this vane type rotary compressor. And you know that when it is coming here in this position, we have seen that some spring loaded vane slide is shown here, and when it is rotating, this shaft is rotating, okay, by the help of some electrical work. Okay, it is rotating by the help of some mechanical work, but that shaft is rotating by the help of some motor or electrical work. Okay, so what happened, as it is spring loaded, so the vane type compressor two or more number of vanes are mounted in the slot of the rotor mounted in the eccentric. Then you can see that it is eccentric, it is like shape is like eccentric. Okay, so what happened, the vane position is controlled as the rotor rotates. Okay, so this vane position, you can see it is controlled, and rotor is rotating. So and they can, you can be used up to 180 Kelvin temperature. Okay, the compression ratio is limited here, 7:1, and has very high volumetric efficiency. Okay, what is the volumetric efficiency here? 70-85%. Okay, the rotary compressor is basically working. You can see when it is rotating, then what happened, this inlet, from the inlet part, the refrigerant is entering, and when there is some pressure is exerted on it, so what happened, the vein from the because of this eccentric shape, the refrigerant is taking its path and it is moving towards the delivery pipe. Okay, and after the delivery pipe, it is entering to the condenser pipe. So here, in the this is the function of the rotary compressor. You can see here, this is the vane, 50% suction. This is a 90% suction, 25% suction, 1% suction. What happened? So this is, you can see, the at first the it is entering, the refrigerant is entering, then it is compressed by the help of this eccentric shape of rotor, and then the refrigerant is not allowed to move in the inlet or in the inlet portion, and it is easily coming towards the, here in the figure you can see 25% suction, in the figure you can see 50% suction, and in the figure you can see 99% suction. So when it is just rotating like an eccentric shape, then it is swiping the particular refrigerant, and then it is allowed to move towards the delivery pipe. Okay, and this is how this process is going on, and this is used for the domestic refrigerant, domestic purpose. Okay, in case of roller type rotary compressor, you can see this is also some eccentric shape, you can see here. So what happened, one spring is, you can is placed here, this is a spring. Now the red color space which is shown here, that is your high pressure vapor, and this green or you can say blue color, it is your low pressure vapor. So what happened here, the rotary, in case of rotary compressor, in this figure, in this type of compressor, the roller is eccentrically mounted on motor. Okay, the roller is eccentrically mounted on motor shaft space having spring loaded blade. Okay, and the whole assembly should be placed in airtight housing and dipped in the compressor oil, and now the vapor is compressed to high pressure by the compressor by the action of the rotor shaft. Okay, now the lower pressure vapor enters gets compressed and finally discharged to the condenser. This type of machine are manufactured up to 5 ton capacity and are quite suitable for low pressure stage in a multi-stage system. So this figure is showing the roller type rotary compressor, and you can see this is your housing, this is cylinder, eccentric, the shape is eccentric, and the your roller, this is your roller, this one is your rotor shaft, this is the suction pipe, and this is the discharge or delivery pipe. Okay, so ultimately our motto is to compress the particular refrigerant. To compress the particular refrigerant in this type of compressor, the roller is eccentrically mounted, you can see here, it is easily you can see here, and mounted on the motor shaft space having spring loaded blade, and the whole assembly should be placed in airtight housing and deep in the compressor oil. Okay, so here inside that particular portion, it is deep into the compressor oil. Okay, so this compressor oil, you can see this one here, it is your compressor oil, and this compressor oil is basically minimizing the friction or frictional dissipation, or it is used for lubrication purpose. Okay, so the whole assembly should be placed in airtight housing and deep in the compressor oil, and now the vapor is compressed to high pressure by this compressor. Okay, now the vapor is compressed to high pressure by the compressor by the action of the rotor shaft. Okay, and the lower pressure vapor enters gets compressed and finally discharged to the condenser. Okay, so ultimately this is our motto. It's to discharge this refrigerant towards the condenser before after compressing it one, in this one. Okay, and this is the capacities are 5 ton, as already have told you. So this is the function, this is the working principle of rotary roller type rotary compressor. Very useful, and it is for multi-stage system. Okay, low pressure stage in a multi-stage system, it is very suitable. And the machine is manufactured up to 5 ton capacity. Okay, so this is the function. And here already I have told you the reciprocating compression, the roller type, rotary compressor. And rotary compressor is two type, roller type and vane type. Now let us discuss here in this figure. You can see the more elaborate way. You can see here the every part is shown here. The spring, basically this spring is moving in, that means by the help of the stiffness property, the spring is moving your horizontally. And what happened, this blade here, in you can see this blade, it is sometime it is forcefully it is moving towards right and towards left. Okay, so when the suction, in the suction pipe, when the refrigerant which is entering, then at that time it is what happened, the after entering into the rotor, into the system, what happened, they by the help of the eccentric shape, and at this particular shaft is rotating, and the spring is basically compressed, and it is the refrigerant is placed somewhere in the middle portion. And when it is coming towards the suction pipe, and it is sweep away the particular refrigerant, and the discharge pipe to the way of the refrigerant will be towards the discharge pipe. Okay, so this is how the function is. It is function. It is also shown in figure 1, completion of intake stroke and beginning of the compression in this point. In the figure number 2, it is shown the compression stroke continued, new intake stroke started. And in the figure number 3, it is shown compression continued, new intake stroke continued. And in the figure number 4, compressed vapor discharge to the condenser, new intake stroke continued. So by the help of these four different figure, we can see the how the process is going on. In the first figure, it can be said that the completion of the intake stroke, that means the intake stroke is completed, and beginning of the compression. Now is compression is taking place right now. So the at that time the valve is totally in suction valve is totally closed. You can see now it is compressed. Now after the it is compressed, then what happened, the compression in the figure number 2, you can easily when it is compressed, then the pressure is increased. So the red portion is basically determining the indicating the pressure is increased. Okay, high pressure represent. Okay, so we can see that it is like a red shape or your orange shape. So this part is compressed, so compression stroke continued, so it is continued, and new intake stroke started. In the same time, you can see in the suction pipe some new refrigerant, low pressure, low temperature refrigerant coming into the system, which is from where it is coming. It is coming from the evaporator. Okay, so in the third diagram, you can easily see that the 50-50%, that means 50% compression, that means whatever the compressed refrigerant, it is coming towards the discharge pipe and coming towards the condenser. So here the compression continued. So compression is continued and it is finding its way where it wants to go. Okay, and new intake stroke continued. Now here 50% refrigerant, you have seen that it is entering into the system. So new intake stroke continued, and after that the last stage, that is your number four stage, it is your compressed vapor discharge to the condenser. Okay, it is you can say the 90% process or 95% process has been completed. So then the red portion, you can see that it is totally entering into the coming out from the compressor, and it is entering into the condenser where it will be condensed. Okay, and here the 70%, you can see 70% suction stroke is taken place, 70 to 80%. So here all the refrigerant which is coming from the evaporator is entering to the compressor by the help of the suction pipe, and ultimately the suction stroke will be taking place. So this is the function, this is the working principle, how it is operated. I hope it is clear. Very, very important, this diagram you need to draw in your exam. So rotary compressor, you can see again the some diagram is shown here. Compression side, rotary compression, this is your this is your another that means type of here compressor. The centrifugal compressor is next, this is centrifugal compressor. So the centrifugal compressor, by the help of the centrifugal force, you know, centrifugal pipe, a pump. So by the help of centrifugal centrifugal force, the compression is taking place. Okay, so let us discuss what is centrifugal compressor, how it is working, and who was the inventor of the centrifugal compressor. So the name of the inventor is Dr. Willis S. Carrier. Okay, Dr. Willis S. Carrier in 1922 developed the centrifugal compressor for refrigeration system. Okay, in this compressor, centrifugal force changes low pressure vapor with high pressure vapor. Okay, so what happened? This compressor is generally used for the refrigerant. Refrigerant that requires large displacement and low condensing pressure, such as R11, R113. However, R12 refrigerant is also used for large capacity and low temperature application. Okay, so this is the compressor which is generally used for the refrigerant R11, R113. Okay, and for requirement of the large displacement and low condensing pressure. Okay, so again I'm telling you, Dr. Willis S. Carrier in 1922. Okay, so it is developed by this particular scientist, and centrifugal refrigeration compressor finds a wide application because they are characterized by the characteristics by the following. You can see the large capacity is there. Okay, so large capacity at very low temperature, they have the ability to carry varying loads with efficiency at all loads. Okay, within their operating range. Okay, so because of this, we are using the wide application of the centrifugal compressor. Okay, so the capacity is very, very large, and at very low temperature they have the ability to carry varying loads with efficiency at all loads within their operating range. So this is all about the centrifugal function. Now the working principle, how it is operated. You can see the centrifugal pump, it is same as the centrifugal pump. It is the shape of the vane is like a spiral shape. Volute casing you can see here, and vaneless diffuser you can see. Okay, and the impeller, this impeller is like a spherical shape, and inlet casing you can see here. And what happened when the particular, this is the outlet of the compressor, and here it is your inlet. Okay, so it is the reverse of the, and that means here you can see the centrifugal compressor is similar to the construction of centrifugal pump, where the incoming gas enters the eye of the spinning spinning impeller and is thrown by centrifugal force to the periphery of the impeller. Okay, that causes the blades of the impeller to impart high velocity to get to the gas, also the also to build up the pressure from the impeller. The gas then flows into diffuser blade or into a volute, where some of the kinetic energy is converted into pressure energy. Okay, so essentially in this speed unit, centrifugal compressor may be directly driven by steam turbine. Okay, and steam turbine, electric motor or internal combustion engine. Okay, so this is the working, and in case of single stage centrifugal compressor, the compression ratio that an impeller can develop is limited to 4.5. okay, when high compression ratio is required, multi-stage centrifugal compressor with intercooler are employed. Okay, so at that time what will happen, we are using multi-stage compressor and some intercooler will be required, because at the outlet of the compressor, what we will see, that the temperature is raised, so the parts or the mechanical parts of the compressor may damage. So that is why intercooler is needed, and ultimately we need to have some high pressure vapor refrigerant. So intercooler are employed, and centrifugal compressor have no valves, piston and cylinder. Okay, it is having no valves, piston, cylinder. The main bearings are the only wiring parts. Okay, so this is the working principle of centrifugal compressor. So here it is entering into the spinning part of the impeller, and outlet you can see easily. Okay, so the basic advantage, I can say that due to the advantage and disadvantage of the centrifugal compressor over reciprocating compressor, okay, I can say that due to the absence of unbalanced masses, these compressor operate with little or no vibration as compared to reciprocating compressor. This compressor due to high speed can handle large volume of vapor refrigerant, and the working life is more owing to the absence of the valve, piston, cylinder, connecting rod, etc. Operation is quiet and calm. Okay, and this compressor can be directly connected to electric motor or steam turbine as they run at high speed, like 3000 rpm or above, and considerably high efficiency will be getting from this compressor as compared to the reciprocating compressor. The large size compressor, large size centrifugal compressor requires less floor area. Okay, so these are the advantages of the centrifugal compressor over reciprocating compressor. Okay, so one last advantage is especially it adapted for system ranging from 550 to 5000 ton. Also employed the temperature range between -90 degree to +10 degree centigrade. Okay, and the disadvantage is what? There are two or three disadvantages. Surging means the reversal of the flow of refrigerant from compressor to evaporator when refrigeration load decreases. Okay, surging occurs when the refrigeration load decreases to about 35% of the rated capacity and causes severe condition in the compressor. And the next is your disadvantage, pressure increase per stage is less as compared to the reciprocating compressor. Now if I am talking next disadvantage, practicable below 50 ton capacity load, and it requires required more refrigerant which should have high specific volume. So these are the four main disadvantages. We will be discussing it afterward elaborately. So I hope it is clear. So if you are having any doubt, ask me in the comment section, and whatever I have discussed, that is your assignment, submit to my given mail ID. So today up to this, thank you for listening. Jai Hind.